the amount of momentum that an object has is dependent to variable.
Run, Venus!
Our poor Doris is all the way, like...
This is a ball. That is working.
It's bouncing. We have this ball, right? Like, can you bounce it? We see how it goes, like, lower each time? That's because, momentum is not conserved because, like, the vector is, like, pushing up and going down at the same time, but it's losing momentum.
Yeah. Right, and as with bouncing, the impulses are greater when the object bounces as when the object hits the ground, the impulse doubles.
Yeah, and because it has mass and the momentum of it, it's going to continue, but because it's not conserved, it's not actually keeping the same amount of distance each time.
Collision. A collision in which kinetic energy is not conserved due to the action of internal friction.
So the formula for inelastic collision is m1v1 plus m2v2 equals v3. Basically, what inelastic collision is like if two things hit each other, rather than like bouncing off or repelling, they continue to move together. So we're going to demonstrate that for you with an egg drop. Wait.
So I'll just put it on the table. Okay. Yeah. Two, one.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Is bounce. Bounce.
Yeah.
Alright. So, when we throw a ball onto the ground, the ball goes back up due to impulse.
Yay.
Yay. Bouncing is like a double impulse. There is one impulse that makes it stop, and another impulse that makes it come back up.
Mass times velocity, or mass times speed. It is the product of the mass and velocity of an object that has magnitude and direction, making it a vector quantity.
So momentum can basically just be described as mass in motion. This tennis ball has no momentum because there is no direction, velocity, or movement. It has mass, but that's about it. However, when Jack pushes it slightly or taps it, when he taps it, it rolls and it has momentum because it moves in a set direction, it has velocity, it has mass, and it is in movement, which means it has momentum. So if Jack pushes it harder, it has more momentum because it has more speed, which increases the momentum.
To you guys about impulse. This person has nothing to do with it. So impulse is the amount of applied force that occurs over a certain interval of time, and it's often measured in...
is equal to the change in momentum of the object that the impulse acts upon.
In order to find the amount of momentum, you can multiply the amount of force applied and the time that it was applied. So you can have different formulas for momentum depending on how much force or time you would use. So for our first example, you can have a small amount of force and a small amount of time that is applied. That's the first one. Then for another one, you can have a small amount of force and a longer amount of time it was applied. Yes. And then for our third example, you can have a large amount of force and a small amount of time. Yes. And then for our fourth example, you probably can guess it. It's a large amount of force and a large amount of time. And if it's executed properly, it works.
And the definition is a property of a moving body that the body has by virtue of its mass and motion, and that is equal to the product of the body's mass and velocity. And I know there's like a lot of words, like what does it mean? Well, in simple words, it's the strength or force an object has when something is moving. And we use a formula. P equals mv, m being mass, and v being velocity. And why is this relevant? Well, we know that momentum is mass and velocity, meaning that that when we are moving, we have momentum. So momentum is everywhere, which is why it is so crucial, and when in contact with another force, can be extremely dangerous.
Okay, so here are some examples. So this is a little video that we found, and so the truck is colliding with the car, and because of its momentum, it ends up moving the car that way. And then we're gonna do one of us two.
So we collided into each other, and because of our momentum, we bounced back.
An elastic collision is an encounter between two objects in which the total kinetic energy of two objects remains the same. In an ideal, perfectly elastic collision, kinetic energy is not then converted into other forms such as heat, noise, or potential energy. In both elastic and inelastic collisions, momentum is conserved, but in elastic collisions, is the total kinetic energy is the same before and after collision. In elastic collisions, we can say elastic collision has two versions. First one is one bolt is the stop object, it's called formula. M1 V1 equals M1 V1 prime plus M2 V2 prime. Our second one, the collision each other is M1 V1 plus M2 V2 is M1 V1 prime plus M2 V2 prime. Okay, further example, the elastic collision is the ball is hitting each other and it makes no noise.